Hi friends, welcome to Naya Videos. Today I would like to share how to maximize your AdSense revenue using DoubleClick for publishers. How we should use these DoubleClick publishers to increase your AdSense revenue. It is one place to get complete reports about your ad statistics, and you can also set the prices for your ads, and you can display as per that CPM prices you mention in your ad slot. So when you log into DoubleClick for publishers, you will see the cards, leaderboard, network snapshot, and release notes. If you want anything, you can simply click this. Like there is a saved filters, network snapshots, release notes, and favorites. If you want to display the tutorials, you can simply check this one and add to dashboard. Once you click that, you can see the tutorial will be added to your dashboard. Like this, you can add cards to your home screen dashboard. So now today I will like to discuss how to integrate media.net ads into your DoubleClick for publishers ads. How to create ad inventory using this. So let us go to the ad units. Once you click to the ad units, once you loaded, you can create the ad unit. I already created some Google AdSense ad units. In the next video, I will show you how to create a Google AdSense ad unit. For now, I will show how to create a, you can select the current level. So ad unit is, we need to write the name of the ad unit. The ad channel is media one, and adx. In which website you are displaying, it is my e-knowledge tree, and the size of the, and where you want to display, like a sidebar below, sidebar down, and what is the size of your ad. My size of ad is 300 into 250. This is for to know where your ad is displayed and what media, what ad network you are showing in your website. You can write a description in the future for the future use. Media .net ad for e-knowledge tree .com. I'm mentioning the website sidebar ad slot 300 into 250, which helps in the future. And now we need to select the size of the ad. Here they are, you can see the size of the ad. Simply select that one. This is a medium rectangle, select that one. And later you can see here the target window, there is an option like top and blank. So if you select the blank, if a user click on the ad, the window will be open and the website will be load on a new window. So if you don't want to display on new window, you can simply select top, open the ads in the landing page itself. Like if you click the ad, it will load in the same window. So by selecting this top, the bounce rate will be more to your website. So I prefer blank to select this. Now this placements is an optional one. You can simply check this, and you can show here it is an AdSense. It is enabled. And override, if you want to override, you can simply maximize revenue of unsold, and this is an AdSense one. You can simply uncheck this one and save the ad. So now we created the ad unit. This is the ad unit. The AdSense inventory settings is disabled for this one. And if you want to get the tags, you can simply generate the tags. Later we will generate the tags. For now, we will create an order for this ad unit. For this ad unit, we need to create the order. Simply click the order. Once the orders is loaded, once you click the orders, you will see different types of ads already created in these orders. I already created some Google AdSense ads. It is running here. This is the status delivering, and another two is ready to delivery. So now create the new order. This is the name of the ad unit we already created. So select searching for this. The company is not there, right? You can simply add media.net, save. This is media.net advertiser, and now you can simply save here the same thing, like media adx sidebar. This is one, and standard, you can simply select the ad unit size once again. This is medium rectangle. Now we need to select the settings, type of the inventory, like sponsorship, standard. Sponsorship ads is a low pricing ads, and standard is the Google standard ads. Network is we can set the CPM price. So for this it is a price priority, so we go for the price priority. Immediately we need to start, and the end time is unlimited. So price priority means how many impressions you are offering for this ad. Like suppose if you provide the 10,000 impressions and set the value of the CPM, like if you want it is in India, so it is showing the rupee symbol. So for that, based on that, I am showing like 300 rupees. It is around $4 for every 1,000 impressions. You can set the absolute value. So this is a discount value, like this, suppose 10%, no, zero. Okay, fine. We are selecting the absolute value. Suppose if you want the discount, suppose if you want to give a discount, you can select 5. So percentage in percentage, 5% discount. And one or more optimized, and you need to select the ad unit. This is media unit. You can simply include the ad unit, and we need to go for upload creatives. It is saved, and we need to too high, so the value is too high, so we will go for absolute value and the discount. So we'll go for 250. Check once again. Yeah, it is saved now. So this is a third party ad. So we need to go for third party ads. I need to get the code of the ad from media.net. The ad units, go to the ad units. And our ad size is 350 250. Simply copy that one and go to, simply paste here. This is media net ads under 350, like sorry, 300 into 250 for the future reference. We added the, sorry, we don't have recognized this tag. If you want to track the via DN, avoid counting depreciation. So this is an outside ad has been inserted. This is a click micro. It will calculate the clicks. You can simply save this one. So we need to approve the ad to display your media.net ads. And your ad is approved. It is in the ready stage. So now you can place your ad code. Go to the ad units. And simply check the media ad net. And generate the tags. So here, generate the tag. Select the tag type is Google Publisher Ads. Publisher tag and click continue. And click, don't change anything, any settings here. You can simply click continue and you will get the target tag here. So place this code in your website, which is a CMS or else whichever website you want to display, you simply go to the website. Sorry. First copy this one, paste in between the header tag. I'm pasting here. So for this script, I already placed in the top. Instead of duplicate, I am removing this script. Update the file. Once it is updated, you simply copy the next code. This is one. This is the ad code where you want to display the ads. Copy this ad code and paste in your sidebar inventory and go to appearance widgets. And add the widget here. Simply come down, add the text widget. The widget is added. Select the text editor and paste the add code here. So simply click save button and it is done. Like this we can add any other ad network to your double click for publishers. You can also add your custom in-house advertisements to your double click for publishers. You can simply add the media and links, and you can also promote the affiliates, affiliate programs, and you can also add Google AdSense to this double click. You can simply integrate, you can simply integrate and display your ads. So just now we integrated this, it will take nearly 30 minutes to display the ads. Let us check whether it is displaying the ad or not. So I already created the Google AdSense ads. You can see in my right sidebar, one which displays in the right sidebar. You can see. The first two ads are displaying from double click for publishers. I added my AdSense account to that and displaying the ads. And you can see in the downside, you can see the ad. This is media.net ads. Like this, you can show your advertisements, you can create your ads. Thanks for watching Naya videos for Google AdSense integration to double click for publishers. I will publish the next video. For more updates, please subscribe to Naya videos. Thanks for watching.